Welcome. If you want to know how long it takes to rise 34 meters while in the London Eye, starting from the rightmost point, you have to solve an equation involving the sine of this duration. Typically, equations involving angles include trigonometric functions as sines and cosines. In this video, I will show you how to solve such equations. Let us begin with the most basic kind of equation. Consider the angle x, which satisfies sine of x equals a half. You can look in the table of the sine function and see that pi over 6, or 30 degrees, is a solution. You can also find this solution from your calculator by using the sine inverse button. This angle must thus be pi over 6, right? What else could it be? Well, consider the triangle on the slide. That is not a 30 degree angle, but its sine is also equal to a half. Let us look at the graph of sine of x. We add the horizontal line at y equals a half. The intersections of this line with the graph of sine of x are the solutions to the equation sine of x equals a half. We see that there are many solutions. Pi over 6 is just one solution. How can you find the other solutions, knowing pi over 6 is a solution? You can use the properties of the graph and of the sine function to find these others. The simplest property is that the sine is periodic, so the graph remains the same if we shift it a distance 2 pi horizontally. The red points of intersection are obtained by adding a multiple of 2 pi to the original solution. So we have 13 pi over 6 and 25 pi over 6, and to the left, minus 11 pi over 6, and so on. The green point is obtained by using the symmetry of the graph of the sine upon reflecting in the line x equals pi over 2. This reflection sends x to pi minus x, so it is pi minus pi over 6 equals 5 pi over 6. The other green solutions can be subsequently found by adding multiples of 2 pi to 5 pi over 6. You can see in the graph that we have now found all solutions. We find infinitely many solutions to this equation. How can you describe all these solutions without using an infinite amount of ink? You can do this by giving a formula which describes all solutions. For example, you can write x equals pi over 6 plus 2 pi k, or x equals 5 pi over 6 plus 2 pi k, where k is an integer, either positive or negative. By plugging in all integer values of k, you obtain all solutions of the equation. For k equals 0, you obtain pi over 6 and 5 pi over 6. For k equals 1, you obtain 13 pi over 6 and 17 pi over 6, etc. You have now seen how to solve a basic equation sine of x equals constant. A similar method works for cosine x equals constant. Find one solution using a table or a calculator, and shift and reflect this solution to get the other ones. Other equations involving trigonometric functions first have to be simplified to this form. There are two basic ways to do this. The first method is to use a substitution. Consider the example cosine of x squared minus cosine of x equals 3 quarters. You can replace cosine of x by a new variable p. Using this substitution, the equation simplifies to p squared minus p equals 3 quarters. You should make sure no stray x's remain in your equation. You need to have an equation involving only p's and no x's, as we do here. We can solve this equation for p as p equals minus a half, or p is 3 over 2. Thus, we find that x satisfies cosine of x equals minus 1 half, or 3 over 2. We now have two equations of the basic form. The second equation has no solutions, as a cosine is always between minus 1 and 1. For the first equation, we need to solve cosine of x equals minus 1 half. Let us consider the graph and the table of cosine of x. There are no negative values in our table, but the cos inverse button of our calculator will still work. We can do better than using our calculator, though. We can expand our basic table to x values from 0 to pi, and we know that the cosine takes negative values from pi over 2 to pi. Another symmetry of the graph shows that those values mirror the values of the cosine from 0 to pi over 2, but with a minus sign. Thus, we see that cosine of pi over 3 equals 1 half implies that cosine pi minus pi over 3 equals minus 1/2. This gives our first answer. Reflecting 2 pi over 3 in the y-axis gives the green solution minus 2 pi over 3. The remaining solutions are 2 pi shifts of plus or minus 2 pi over 3. All solutions can thus be expressed as 2 pi over 3 plus 2 pi k or minus 2 pi over 3 plus 2 pi k. Let us go back to our original example and use these solutions. As a final step, we check that these are valid by plugging these in our equation, using that cosine of x equals minus 1/2 for all of them. Warning! If you want to use a substitution, a common mistake is to use a substitution that leaves some x's remaining in the resulting equation. For example, if you use p equals cosine of x in the equation x times cosine of x equals 1 to get x times p equals 1, we have an x remaining. This must not happen. The final equation should only contain the new variable. In the previous example, you have used a substitution to simplify your equation to the basic form cosine of x equals c. A second method for simplifying is to use trigonometric identities. Consider the example cosine of x times sine of x equals 1/4. Recall that sine of 2x is 2 times cosine of x times sine of x. Thus, we recognize the result of the doubling formula for the sine in our equation. Using this, the equation simplifies to sine of 2x equals 1/2. We can now use that we already solved sine of x equals 1/2 to obtain that 2x equals pi over 6 or 5 pi over 6 plus 2 pi k. Dividing by 2 gives our final solution. In summary, there are two important aspects to solving equations involving trigonometric functions. To solve a more complex equation, you need to first simplify it to a basic equation. Use a substitution whenever this is possible. Remember that no x's are allowed in the resulting equation. Otherwise, you should look for a simplifying trigonometric identity. We reviewed them in week 2. Be on the lookout for things like sine squared plus cos squared and the results of doubling formulas and addition formulas, as you want to go from complicated expressions to easier ones. Sometimes you may even need to combine both methods. To solve a basic equation, sine of x equals constant or cosine of x equals constant, you first find a single solution by looking in the table or using your calculator, and subsequently use the graph of the function to obtain all other solutions. Try these techniques yourself today.